I went to dental school because everyone in my family is an entrepreneur, and I wanted to be an entrepreneur also. And I knew that if I had went into medicine, my chances of being an entrepreneur were pretty slim. So I liked working with my hands, and dentistry seemed kind of a natural fit for me. I went to dental school at the University of Minnesota. I did my undergraduate at the University of Arizona, Bear Down, Arizona. So from after dental school, I worked at a couple different offices. Let me back up. After dental school, I did a residency for a year in Knoxville, Tennessee, learning some additional dentistry, some techniques and things that dental school just doesn't have time to teach, which is it has made a huge difference in my career. Then I came back to town and worked at a couple different offices, some good, some bad. It made me realize that I had a very specific vision for what I wanted to do and the group of people I wanted to make a difference for. And it's outside the norm of most practices, so I needed to start my own. So in dental school, we're taught that patients who don't complete their treatment plans or don't come in and do all their work and all those things, they're bad patients and you shouldn't make time for them. And in my mind, that could not be further from the truth. I want to help everybody, but I really want to help patients who have tremendous fear, tremendous phobia. They've been away from the dental office for 5, 10, 15, 20, even 30 or 40 years. I've had a number of grown adults who have never been to a dentist that have come to see me, and they're afraid, they're scared, and most offices don't want to deal with them. It's different dealing with them. It's more challenging. I love it. That's why I get up every day.